a new problem from Pathfinder Kinematics. Challenge your understanding. So if you see the problem, an L is equal to 70 meter long thin tape wound on a spool of radius small r is equal to 110 millimeter makes a tape roll of outer radius 25 millimeter. A motor used to wind the tape rotates the spool at a constant angular velocity and takes capital T is equal to 165 seconds to complete the winding. Calculate length of the tape which has been wound in small t is equal to 110 seconds from the beginning of the winding. So this is the problem. Let us proceed to the solution. So if you see the solution, you will get the full clarity on the problem. This is a very nice problem. Here if you take the spool is there here. The inner radius of this spool is, they have given that inner radius of this spool is R naught. And the outer radius including winding, the outer radius including winding is given. Just see the outer radius including winding. The outer radius including winding is capital R. Capital R is the outer radius including winding, and this is the tape. So from coming from this portion, okay, when you unwind it completely, it will turn into a straight wire of length capital L. So I want to show you that. So I will give you a shade with red color. So this is the area of the portion that is obtained due to winding of the wire. Okay, so when you unwind it, it will turn into a straight wire. It will turn into a straight wire of length capital L, and this wire having some small thickness. This delta capital T is the thickness. So delta capital T is the thickness that is very much small, most small. And you can relate this two areas. So this is the area of the cross section of the winding, and this is the wire side area, wire sided area. So now this is a rectangle and having length L and the thickness is delta T. So this area of this wire, this area is given by L into delta T. So that equal to, when you unwind it, it is turning into a wire of length L. So this area and this area both are equal. So you can equate this area, shaded cross section, is pi into capital R square minus R naught square. So this is equation one. So now what you are doing is you are rotating the spool with the help of motor with a constant angular speed. Okay, so when you rotate the motor with the help of spool with a constant angular speed, then what will happen? If the motor used to wind rotates with constant velocity omega, then radius of the winding increases uniformly. This point is very, very important point. Now we are going to draw the graph of how the radius of the winding increases uniformly with the time. Now if you see the graph will be like this. So here radius is taken on y-axis, time is taken on x-axis. Initially the radius is R naught because only spool radius is there, but gradually along with the time the radius of the winding will increases because more and more portion of the thread will wind to the spool. So that's why the radius will increases like this uniformly, and the total radius will becomes capital R when the complete wire is wounded to the spool. And this is the time T, capital T is the time after which the total wire is completely being wounded to the wire. And you can see this is any intermediate radius. and this is the time at that instant. Now we are required to relate the radius at any time t with the capital R and R naught and capital T. By using the mathematics we can easily relate, because this length is capital R minus R naught, and you see this length, this is small r minus R naught, and you can see from the diagram this is capital T and this is small t. So now you can take, by using similar triangles, you can easily relate by taking the corresponding sides must be in the same ratio, because these two triangles are similar. So capital R minus R naught divided by small r minus R naught is equal to, so this is the capital T, and you can directly write capital T divided by small t. Now see how to relate this radius, is very easy, and you can take this capital R this side, capital R minus R naught divided by capital T is equal to R minus R naught divided by small t, and you are getting R is equal to R naught plus capital R minus R naught divided by capital T into small t. So this is the radius of the winding at any time t. Okay, so now let us see length of the tape consumed in that instant. I don't know the length of the tape consumed in that instant. Suppose we are winding the tape to the spool, and this is a intermediate situation, and this is the inner radius R naught, but outer radius is small r. So small r is the radius of the winding at time t. Okay, so at this instant what is the length of the wire consumed? Suppose small l be the length of the wire consumed at this instant. Small l is the length of the wire consumed in this instant. So small l is the length of the wire consumed. If you unwind that small l portion, again it will becomes a wire of length small l. So this is the shaded portion. You can see this is the shaded portion. Again you can relate these two areas, because whatever the area of the unwinded wire, so that will be the area of the rectangle, and this thickness is, I already told you, delta t. So this area of this small rectangular portion is L into delta t. Now you can relate this area. This area is already, you know, that pi into capital R square minus R naught square. So this is the equation 2. So we already know about equation 1. This is the equation 1 that we got. You see this equation. We have already computed this equation. This is the equation that we got. And this is the second equation that we are having. This is the second equation that we are having. Now let us divide equation 1 and equation 2. Equation 1 and equation 2. So equation 1 divided by equation 2 gives and pi into capital R square minus R naught square divided by pi into small r square minus R naught square. That is equal to capital L into delta T divided by small l into delta T. So this small thickness will cancel, and finally what we are having, the small l is equal to capital L into R square minus R naught square divided by capital R square minus R naught square. So this is the thing, but R is the radius at a particular instant of time t of the winding. Now you have to plug that value of the radius here, and you have to obtain the length of the wire consumed at that instant of time. So you can write that value here. I already computed the value of this R. R value is R naught plus capital R minus R naught divided by capital T into small t. So I am writing this here, and R naught plus and capital R minus R naught divided by capital T into small t whole square minus R naught square divided by R square minus R naught square. So this is the finally the length of the wire consumed at an instant of time t. So you can write the final answer in this manner. So this is R naught plus R minus R naught divided by capital T into small t whole square minus R naught square. So divided by capital R square minus R naught square. So this is the thing that we are having. Now we have to plug all the values that we are having here. We are already having the values of R naught. R naught is 110 millimeter and capital R is 25 millimeter. And capital T is already known, that is 165. Capital T is 165 and small t is 110. Now you have to put all the values. And now let us see what is the value of L we are getting. So L we are getting as 40 meters. 40 meters is the wire. If you substitute all the values, then we will get the 40 meters. So this is the answer for the problem. Okay. Thank you for watching, students, and you can do the remaining computation. It's very easy. Just by substituting all these values and after calculation, you will definitely get the 40 meters, no doubt. So this is the perfect method to solve this pathfinder problem. Thank you.